Hey everyone, Pete Estes here. Welcome to another episode of Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY. Let's get today started with another weekly award for a Catamount diver. Vermont freshman Emily Murphy became the second Catamount rookie this season to win the AmeriEast Diver of the Week award. Murphy posted a season best score of 238.72 points in the 1 meter dive to win the event against Maine last weekend. The Cats swept the diving events with Ashley Brannigan winning the 3 meter dive. UVM is back home this weekend for a dual meet against Bryant at Forbush Natatorium starting at 11 a.m. Live video will be available on catamounttv.com. The AmeriEast announced postseason awards for men's soccer last week, and a pair of Cats took home major awards. Junior Gio Alves was voted as the Fans' Choice Player of the Year after his first season with the Catamounts. Alves scored a league-best 9 goals this season. Meanwhile, sophomore goalkeeper Aaron Renerson was named the AmeriEast Goalkeeper of the Year. Renerson made 51 saves in 14 games and posted 3 clean sheets in a season that saw the Cats claim the regular season championship. Vermont fell to defending conference champion Albany in the league semifinals last night, but not before posting 10 wins under first-year head coach Rob Dow. That's the most wins under a first-year head coach at Vermont since the 1975 squad won 11 games under Paul Reinhardt. Elsewhere, women's soccer midfielder Brooke Jenkins, who scored the game-winning goals in both of Vermont's postseason victories en route to the AmeriEast title game, was named the recipient of the league's Elite 18 Award. The award is given to the student-athlete with the highest grade point average competing in the championship. The regular season is finally here for the Vermont men's basketball team. The Cats travel to take on number 4 Kentucky this Sunday, and head coach John Becker thinks his Cats will be ready to play.
As a coach, we're always trying to find that balance of making it, you know, light and fun, but not too much where guys lose their focus and their edge. And so, this experienced group, and they know what it takes, and you can just see the screws tighten a little bit as the St. Mag's game ended and we turned towards Kentucky. And, you know, the guys will be ready to play, I'm sure.
Fans can head over to uvmathletics.com for a list of watch locations for the nationally televised contest. Fans attending the game are welcome to check out the pregame reception at the Hyatt Regency Lexington Hotel starting at 1:30. Women's basketball also gets the regular season underway this weekend. The Cats make the quick trip to Dartmouth Friday night before flying to South Beach for Sunday's ACC Network Extra game at Miami. That game can be seen on ESPN3 and the Watch ESPN app. Last weekend, prior to the men's basketball contest against St. Michael's, UVM recognized first responders and emergency service personnel for their efforts this summer as a fire broke out at Torrey Hall. Thanks to their work, 2 priceless and irreplaceable collections housed at Torrey Hall suffered no damage. While both basketball teams are on the road, both hockey teams will hold things down here in Catamount Country, with the women's home-and-home series against defending national champion Clarkson and the men's 2-game set against Boston College. The Gut is the place to be this weekend. Boston College comes to the Gut for just the second time in the last 3 seasons as the Cats look to build on last Saturday's comeback win at UConn. Vermont and BC have played each other in each of the last 3 seasons in the Hockey East quarterfinals. Puck drop is 7:05 both nights, and Saturday is Military Appreciation Night presented by Milton Catt. UVM will wear special edition jerseys, which will be auctioned off following the game. Last season, women's hockey dropped a competitive 3-1 decision to Clarkson in late November and will face the defending national champs Friday afternoon at the Gut. Puck drop between the Cats and the 3rd-ranked Golden Knights is set for 2 o'clock. That'll do it for us today on Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY. As always, plenty more next week right here on Catamount TV.